Aschenfelder developed his formula by estimating a linear regression model. And you will see in this course that basically a lot, even though not all, of empirical economics uses linear regression or some variation of it. So he has a dependent variable on the left-hand side, which measures the quality of a vintage. And this will be derived from the auction prices of the vines. We will come back later how this variable is exactly computed. And then he has different explanatory variables on the right-hand side, which are basically all numerical variables, so they have all some numbers for a particular vintage T. So we have the temperature, that's the average temperature from April to September in the year T, where the wine was grown, so for the vintage T. The rain, average rainfall in the winter months from October to March, and the average rainfall in August, where this vintage was harvested. And he also has another variable, age, and that basically denotes the age of the vintage at the time its quality is measured. And that's basically the time at which the auctions take place, for which we have collected data to analyze the average price of that vintage. For example, if we look at auctions in the year 1990, for the vintage from 1961, the age variable would be 29. Then we have here a final variable called UT, which is often called an error term. And you often use also an epsilon T to denote it. Basically, it measures all other factors that influence the dependent variable, so the quality of the vine, which we have not explicitly included as explanatory variables. Yeah, for example, there's some different weather factors. Maybe the rainfall in May also plays a role. So all these factors can influence it. So we can also call UT an unobserved quality shock of the vintage T. So that's all the other factors that influence the quality, which we don't explicitly account for in our regression model. And then we have these betas. Beta 0, which is a constant, and one coefficient beta for each of the explanatory variables. And these are the unknown coefficients that we want to estimate. And the exact interpretation of these coefficients can differ between the applications. In particular, sometimes we can interpret them in the causal fashion. So we could say beta 1 measures by how much 1 degree higher temperature influences or causally affects the quality of the vine. Sometimes we will only say these are coefficients that tell us how these two variables are correlated or by how much 1 degree higher temperature affects our prediction of the quality, even so it does not necessarily have a causal interpretation. But we will come back to this point later. That will be important in later applications in this course where we really, really want to estimate causal effects but do not necessarily always estimate them just by writing down such a simple regression. So this we'll discuss in much more detail during the course. So for his vine formula, Aschenfelder and his co-authors computed these estimates beta hat of the coefficients in our linear regression using so-called ordinary least squares estimation. You probably have heard about this. In German, it's kleinste quadratische Schätzung in some of your previous statistics classes, but nevertheless, let us briefly repeated here. So if we write the linear regression in a more general form, one typically denotes the dependent variable with a y and the explanatory variables with an x. And let y hat be the predicted value of the dependent variable, given that we have some estimate beta hat of these two coefficients. So we basically replace the betas by our estimates and we set this error term u to 0, and then we get a prediction y hat for every observation. Now the residuals in our data set between the are the differences between the true value of the dependent variable, kind of the true quality of the wine vintage in our example, minus the predicted value. So that's the residual. Now the OLS estimator is that value of all possible beta hats, so these are just a vector of numbers, that minimizes the sum of the squared residuals in the data set we use for our estimation. So these residuals you had, I mean, they are a function of our estimator of the beta hats, right? Because the y hat depends on them. And if we have a different beta hat, we have a different residual. Now we sum up these residuals for any beta hat, or the squared residuals for any beta hat, and choose that vector of beta hat that minimizes this sum of squared residuals. And that's the OLS estimator. And one can basically solve this analytically and gets a closed form solution for this beta hat OLS, which involves some matrix notation, so which I don't want to introduce in this course. But it's actually can be computed relatively quickly as long as we don't have so many explanatory variables. We can have quite a lot of observations, but if we have tens of thousands explanatory variables, then it would be a bit difficult, but usually it goes very fast. And in R, you can, for example, compute OLS estimators with the command LM, which stands for linear model.